Welcome students, this is the continuation of force and motion chapter. Today we are going to learn about center of gravity and stability. So I am going to do an activity, that is I try to balance a mobile phone on my fingertip. See this, you can notice that there is only one point at which the mobile phone is balanced. The point at which the mobile phone is balanced is called the center of gravity of the mobile phone. So what is center of gravity? The center of gravity of an object is the point through which the entire weight of the object appears to act. So see the picture. The center of gravity of an object is a point through which the entire weight of the object appears to act. Next, center of gravity of regular objects. We know that what are regular objects? Objects that have definite shape are called regular objects. For example, square, circle, triangle, these are regular shapes. So generally the center of gravity of the geometrical shaped objects lie on the geometric center of the object. For example, if the object has square in shape, then geometric center of the object is, then for circle, the geometric center of circle is this point. Then for triangle, geometric center of the object is this point. So geometrical shaped objects lie on the center of gravity of the geometrical shaped objects lie on the center of the geometric center of the object. So for example, the ruler scale. The ruler is in equilibrium when supported at its center of gravity. For regular shaped object such as a uniform meter ruler, the center of gravity is at the center of the object. When the object is supported at that point, it will be balanced. If it is supported at any other point, it will topple. So center of gravity of an object is a point through which the entire weight of the object appears to act. Next topic is stability. Stability is a measure of the body's ability to maintain its original position. What is stability? It is a measure of the body's ability to maintain its original position. Three types of stability are stable equilibrium, unstable equilibrium, then neutral equilibrium. Let us demonstrate them by taking a frustum. So this is frustum. So in stable equilibrium, the frustum can be tilted through quite a big angle without toppling. So here its center of gravity is raised when it is displaced. So the original position of the frustum is this. Then it can be tilted through a big angle without toppling. So the center of gravity is raised when it is displaced. The vertical line through its center of gravity still falls within its base. So it can return to its original position. See the picture. So center of gravity, this is center of gravity. It falls within its base. so it can return to its original position. Then, so the center of gravity is at lowest possible position. Then the center of gravity needs to be raised in order to topple the object. So they are difficult to topple over. Then in unstable equilibrium, the frustum will topple with the slightest tilting. Its center of gravity is lowered when it is displayed. Here the vertical line through the through its center of gravity falls outside its basis. So this is the base of the frustum. So here the center of gravity falls outside its base. So it will not come back to its position. So this is unstable equilibrium. So here the center of gravity is lowered. So for unstable object, the center of gravity is at the highest possible position. The center of gravity is lowered in order to topple the object, so they are easy to topple down. Then for neutral equilibrium, it causes frustum to topple. The frustum will roll about but does not topple. Its center of gravity remains at same height. It is displaced. When it is displaced, so the body will stay at any position to which it has been displaced. Condition for stability. Stability can be increased by the following ways: lower its center of gravity, increasing the area of its base. A heavy base lowers the center of gravity, so the object will be stable. Then a broad base makes the object more stable. Next, real life application of center of gravity. In order to have stability, the luggage compartment of a tour bus is located at the bottom and not on the roof. So next one is, extra passengers are not allowed on the upper deck of a crowded double-decker bus. So these are the real life application of center of gravity. So luggage compartment of a tour bus is located at the bottom. Extra passengers are not allowed on the upper deck of a crowded double-decker bus. Next application is, racing cars are built low and broad for stability. Racing cars, so the base is very broad, so these cars built low and broad for stability. Then table lamps, then table fan are designed with large heavy bases to make them stable. Students, hope you all understood about center of gravity and stability. Thank you.